Hi everyone. Wanted to come on and talk to you for just a couple of minutes before I do a little bit of playing around with one of the jelly prints I made the other day. I wanted to mention that YouTube is having some issues with a lot of things lately. And right now it happens to be comments. And I'm having trouble leaving comments for a few of you. And part of that, I think, is the problems that are going on with YouTube. And part of it is also that some of you don't have your settings set in order for me to be able to reply to your comment. So if you are leaving comments for me on my videos and you're not getting any reply from me, because I try to reply to every single person who leaves me a comment. And if I can't reply to you because of the way your settings are configured, then I will usually at least like it. But the problem is that a lot of you are asking me questions and I can't answer them. And I would love to be able to answer them. So if you have asked me questions or you have left a comment and you see that I'm leaving, you know, responses for everyone else but not for yours, please go and check your settings. And sometimes it's in Google Plus, or I mean, that's where I have found the setting that allows you to respond to everyone's comment was in Google Plus. Now, I don't know if YouTube and Google Plus are still a happy family or what's going on with them, but just check and even do a search, you know, on YouTube to find out how you can reply to, or how you can get your settings set up correctly so that others can reply to your comments. So, I didn't want anyone to feel like, you know, I'm ignoring or anything like that, because that's just truly not the case. The next thing I wanted to show you was I did a page in my art journal the other day. I just needed to relax and just play my art journal, so I did not record it. But I do want to share it with you because I used something that I did show you I was making the other day. I used a jelly print. And this is the page that I made. And some of you may recognize the bird is cut from this jelly print that I made the other day in that session, that two-part session. So, what I did was, all of this yellow that you see back here in the background was some yellow paint that I had put on a piece of deli paper. And you know how I like to use those for my backgrounds. There was a little bit of like cleanup paint and stuff on it too. So you'll see these little red markings here and there. And there's some little tiny, just little splotches here and there of the red. I don't know if you can see that or not, but there's some down here. And then there's teeny tiny little bits and pieces around here of red and stuff. That was just some other, you know, colors that were on the jelly plate. And so when I cleaned up the plate, it lifted up all this random color. So it was mostly yellow, and I decided that I had already decided I wanted to use this bird stencil that I just got from Joann's. It's a Donna Downey stencil, and it comes with the masks. You have to kind of snip it out. It's connected there, but it's a stencil, but then you have the masks too you can also use. So I used the smaller bird, and cut out that jelly print. Well, I drew it and cut it out. But before I put it on the page, I had decided that I wanted to make like a sunset sort of scene, and since I had the yellow background, I thought, well, that would be a good start for a sunset scene. So I added a little orange just here and there, just little swipes with a paintbrush, and then I I thought, well, you know, the orange would be enough. And so after that, I stamped these little dragonflies. And I put a little bit of sparkle on the wings. I used a Wink of Stella brush marker. It's in here somewhere. There it is. This is a Wink of Stella brush, and it's got a liquid silvery sparkle in there, and you just brush over, you know, whatever you want to add it to, you just brush over, and it leaves this very, very fine sparkle. And let's see, I did the dragonflies, and when I took a stamp, the stamp came with the Dina Wakely Scribbly Birds stamps, this one, and so this little stamp is the one that I used. And when I stamped it on, I stamped it directly on the page, and when I lifted up the stamp, the quote was upside down. So, I was not paying attention, obviously. So, I had used permanent ink, you know, the stays-on ink, and it stayed on. Because I tried wiping it away real quick, but it wasn't coming up. So, this is what you do when you make a big mistake like that. You cover it up with something and hide it so nobody sees. So I just made a little tag, and I used one of those reinforcement labels that I had painted on the jelly plate the other day. I've shown y'all, I did like two or three colors of the reinforcement labels. They're just more fun to use when they're all painty, you know, than just using a plain white one. So every now and then I'll throw some of those on the jelly plate just to color some up. And so I stamped it again on the tag, that quote, and I edged the tag with one of my pit pins, and then I kind of just squiggled a little border in and tied the little ribbon on. And I got all that done, and I felt like it still didn't look like a very much like a sunset. So I needed to add some clouds. And so I did some clouds, kind of a gray blue and purples, and you know, just kind of blended colors together on my craft mat, and just kind of painted them on in little, you know, linear cloud shapes. And I liked that, and it still wasn't quite enough. So I took some pink and added some pink to the sky. So wherever you see, you know, these pink lines. And these are supposed to represent like, you know, like telephone wires. And that's the page I made, and it just made me happy to make a page, and it was relaxing and fun, and I hope you'll forgive me for not recording it. But some days you just want to just relax and feel free, and you know, I was listening to music and just enjoying, you know, just enjoying it and not having to worry about a video or anything or how it was turning out or anything. So, and I knew I could share it with you after the fact, so that's my little bird page I did with that jelly print. And today I thought I would take another jelly print that I also made the other day. Remember this one? I thought I would take this, and I found a previous jelly print that I had used that same stencil on. I thought I might cut a few of these out. You see, I've already used several of them on other projects. But I thought I might take a couple of these, cut a couple of these out, and maybe just put them on here and there just to add, you know, mix it up and make the colors or add to the colors, I mean. So I'm just going to cut a few. I'm not going to cover all of them, but just cut a few. And I think the ones, interesting ones like that, that have a little different, you know, colors and things added to them, I think might look really cool. also thought that I would take another new stencil I got same day, the other day, when I was shopping at Joann's. I got this stencil from Joggles while I was there. And I thought it would kind of look cool to have this pattern. This is kind of a vertical, you know, pattern on here. So I thought, well, I could add to that and do this in white on top of that, so it would look really stark against all that deep color. But before I do that, I think that I might doodle around some of these shapes and let's see what we could come up with. Okay, I think that that's all the doodling that I'm going to do on it. And since I started doodling on it, I decided that I wouldn't use that stencil that I mentioned earlier because it's kind of wide. I was thinking since I did the doodling, I didn't really want to cover it up. And I thought, well, I could still, you know, do a row of these circles here, but I don't know. I'm thinking now because of the doodles, it might be a little too much. So I'm going to go for a simpler stencil and just do some zigzag lines. I had already used this stencil on here. It got sort of buried, but you can see some blue zigzag lines right there. There's a few down here you can still see up in here. And so I'm going to repeat the zigzag, and I'm going to repeat the blue, but I'm going to use a lighter blue than what I had used previously. I'm going to use this one. This is Indian turquoise. And I'm not going to go over the, I don't think I'm going to go over the areas where the doodling is. I think I'm going to go like in between, you know, here and there. Just see what it looks like, I guess. So let's see where I'll start on this side. Maybe do two rows here because it looks like it's wide enough to get two rows in. Problem is, I don't like using these liquidy paints when I'm doing stenciling. Let me see if I've got a thicker one. I think I do. Okay. Yeah, I've got one. I think it's pretty close. Yeah. All right. So I'm going to use this one, which is light blue permanent. I'm just going to use a makeup sponge to apply it, but I think it'll be bright and you know, it'll help to brighten up what's going on this page. All right. Thinking it's probably going to need a second coat. Well, maybe not. That looks kind of cute. Yeah, I like it. Oh my goodness, I really love it. I really, really love it. Okay, I'm going to add one other color while I have the zigzags out. I'm going to do some partial ones. I think just little bits and pieces here and there where there's a gap. I need to get out another sponge. That'll work. And get my yellow paint. here. I hope this is dark enough to be seen. Well, it's not really very dark at all, is it? I guess I could use white because I didn't use much white, so maybe I'll just use white instead of the yellow. Okay. I'm pretty sure that this was a yellow paint that I used back here, and it mixed with some blue somewhere and made greens. But I'm wondering if I could put a green color on there and it show up right. Let's see. I have both of these, but I like the brightness of the lighter one. You think there's so much yellow that this one is the one that blends the best. I'm gonna just try it and see what's the worst that could happen, right? We just wipe it away or we just leave it alone. No biggie. But I was thinking about like this darker areas, you know, a couple of them here and there that this might show up good. We'll see. We shall see. Okay. When I'm working with my little sponges, I like to keep some water just in a little dish that I can just stand them in so that the paint doesn't so the paint doesn't get real hard, you know, hard to wash out. And just let them sit there and they'll stay soft. And the paint will wash out very easily. See that? Seen, but it really does blend right in with that yellow turned green there. So I don't know, maybe we should try the other little bluish green and just see if it looks any better. Give it a shot. little turquoisey kind of green. Certainly more obvious than the yellow was, and then this green is. Although this green does look good over here in the dark section because there really wasn't any of that yellow there. So I think I'll put another green one here. Let's see. That turned out to be a colorful page. Okay. Sponge is coming apart. But that's okay. I know most of you already know this, but when your sponge starts to fall apart, all you have to do is cut it off. Just like that. Then you have a fresh new sponge again. Just spray this one. And I don't know if I can see that on this blue card, but I'm going to try it. That's kind of cool. It's a good background, good starter card for another time. All right. Now, I think I'm pretty much done with this. I may stamp still a little bit on top, but I'm going to think about it for a little while. And if I decide to do anything more to it, I will certainly show you. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this sheet, but I just wanted to play with it. It just looked like too much fun with the colors that it started with. And to be able to add more to it, you know, is just makes it so much fun. So I hope you guys have a great day. I also want to thank everyone that left me happy birthday messages today. I really appreciate that. It's been a nice day, and it's been lovely to have messages from so many of you. It's just really made a great day for me, so thanks very much. And we will see you again soon on the next video. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.